Good morning, children. Today we will learn about the Fibonacci series. In Python programming, basically in conditional statement, this Fibonacci series is a very, very important program. So let's see what is Fibonacci series. First, we will learn that what is actually Fibonacci series. So just try to understand this one. Fibonacci series will start from 0 and 1. Means the first number in Fibonacci series is 0. Second number will be 1. This is the fixed one. If anyone will ask in a Fibonacci series the first number, tell me the first number of the Fibonacci series, it will be 0. If someone will ask second number of the Fibonacci series, it will be 1. So 1 means the first and second, 0 and 1 will be in the Fibonacci series. Now the third number, how the third number will form. So I'm going to explain third number, how the third number will be formed. So last two digits you have to add. So the last two number, 0 plus 1 means this will be 1. So it will be the third position. It will be third position. Now in the fourth position, what will in the fourth position? So here last two digit, two number you have to add. This last two means this third one and this second one. So when we add this one, so it will be 2. So 2 will be in the fourth position of the Fibonacci series. So now move to the fifth position. So in the fifth position means we have to add this one and then we will get the fifth position. Means we have to, sorry, it will be here 2, not 4 here. Fourth is the position here 2. So we need to add this 2 and 1, then we get the fifth position. So here number of fifth position will be 3. So here we have to write 3. The same way in the sixth position means we have to add this 3 and 2, then we get the sixth position. So here 3 and 2, it will be 5. Means 5 will be in the fifth position. So now the sixth position means we have to add this 5 and 3 means 8. So such a way this Fibonacci series will be generated. Means last two numbers you have to add to get the next number of the Fibonacci series. So let's, we are going to learn through the programming in Python. I have typed this one. So let's see. Yes, look at here. This Fibonacci series, this is the comment line. Here just I'm asking one number, that is enter the limit, means from where, means up to what number you want to generate the Fibonacci series, means kahan tak. Suppose aap chahte Fibonacci series hamara 10 tak hi generate ho, ya 20 number se upar na jao. It just limit you have to set. So I have already told that A, that is the first number of the Fibonacci series, B, that is the second number of, and C, when we add A first and second, then we will get the third one. So now here Fibonacci series, this is a message only. Print A and B. A and B means 0 and 1, it will be printed. Condition will check here. C less than equal to I. Value of I means that limit. So suppose limit I have taken 10. So C is 1 here. So C less than equal to 10. Yes, condition is 2. Obviously C is lesser than 10. So print C. So here C will print, that is the third position of the Fibonacci series. Now we need to change the position. Means the, if you want to get the fourth number, means here what we have to do, the second position will be the third one. That's the swapping part only, and C will be B. Means ek previous number lena hai, jaise bhi humko maan ke chale ki A mein hamara first position tha, B mein second position tha. To ab jo hai B, jo A hamara wo second position chala jana chahiye aur jo C hai wo hamara third position chala jana chahiye. To ye swapping ho raha hai. And then we need to add ye dono A B ko add karenge, then we will get the number. So now I'm going to execute this one, save it and run it. It's asking enter the limit, suppose 10, Now see the Fibonacci series. The first two number it will be displayed, and the third one, 1, then 2, 3, 5, 8, and limit I have set up to 10. Why the next number is not coming? Because 5 and 8, it will be 30, and limit I have set up to 10. So this is the Fibonacci series, and I hope this Fibonacci series is clear to everyone. And just once try to execute this one, and if you face any problem, you can ask. Now, next program I'm going to discuss, that is a reverse number. Reverse number. In the previous video, I have discussed a random number. So, how we will check the number is random or not? So, first we need to reverse the number. So, in this program, nothing we have to do. Just remove this part, and simply write print and REV reverse num, and here you need to print only. Here you need to print what REV you have to print. So let's see what will the result. And this program is not the plain round number, this program is to reverse the number. REVRC reverse number. Save it and run it. It's asking enter the number. Suppose number I have entered 1, 2, 5. So obviously it must be printed 5 to 1. See, reverse number is 5 to 1. So such a way you can reverse the number. And the concept is same. If you see how we are getting the digit, that in the previous video I have discussed. Same way, and mode division 10, then we will get the last digit. Then this one I have discussed how it will be. So finally, after just executing this loop, reverse number will be generated. I hope if you see the video of Brainow number, so this concept you can understand. So you must watch this video and execute. You must dry run in the copy. And if you face any problem, you can raise the question. Thank you.